You know, the grand final, which played at Old Trafford, final game of the season. Obviously, there's not many major trophies to win in rugby league, and it is the theatre of dreams. It's you know, it's an exceptional stadium, and it's hyped up the way it should be. Obviously, the Challenge Cup final with Leeds was a bit of an omen for me. So, been to numerous finals and come out on the back end of you know, the wrong end of the result. The grand final, like I say, it's the final game of the season. And if you finish the season off wrong, it tends to be a very, very long off season. And you're playing your career to win trophies and playing major finals. And like I say, the theatre of dreams, it is an exceptional stadium. The crowd is on top of you. And, you know, the atmosphere is just electric. And, you know, thankfully I've got a lot of fond memories from playing in some great grand finals over my career. Yeah, walking out of the tunnel, it's really special. Like I say, I'm one of them people that enjoys the atmosphere. I'm quite relaxed when it comes into a game. You know, you've got your certain individuals that like to bang their head against a big wall and it takes them hours. Because I remember Rob Burrow, you get to Headingley 2.5 hours before kickoff and he sat there in his full kit. That's how he prepared, whereas I was a little bit more relaxed and like to enjoy the atmosphere. And that's the beauty of the grand final, is the fact that the atmosphere is absolutely electric. Walking out onto the tunnel with the fireworks and the music blaring, it's you know, it's surreal, and you know, just thinking about it, you get the shivers down your spine. You know, and I'm the one that's singing to the music rather than the one that's really focusing on the game, because I felt that I was quite fortunate that I could just flick the switch and I'd be prepared when it came to kickoff time. So you never know whether it's going to be your first or your last. So you know, just savouring the atmosphere is something that's an absolute electric feeling playing in a grand final. Like I say, it's the final game of the season, and it's a very, very long off seal dealing with a loss. And I remember the 2005 final loss, which I was injured for and didn't end up playing. And I remember before the game, just after the game, I saw Kevin Sinfield, absolutely gutted he was. And I said to him, I said, you know, it's better to be involved and have the loss than not to be involved at all. And thinking about that years afterwards, it's something that I massively regret saying, because, you know, to be honest, losing is the worst feeling in the world. You know, to experience it is great. When you've experienced it, you know, to lose is devastating. And, you know, at the end of the day, it is a game. It is just a game, but it's the importance of, you know, of winning that with your mates that you've been working all season for. You know, to fall at the final hurdle is you know, it is heartbreaking, because you put so much effort and so much work into it throughout the season.